Hello and welcome to the Django DRF project, eCommerce. This tutorial is part of a series of tutorials which you can watch for free. The link to the YouTube course playlist is in the video description. This course is also available on Udemy, where you can watch the course ad-free, download the tutorial source code, and access all updated tutorials and playlist. The link to the course, which will always provide the best price, can be found in the video description. In addition to Black, which is going to format visually our code, we can also install a number of different linting tools. Now, the two kind of popular linting tools in Python is Flake8 and PyLint. Now, in this course, I've just decided to utilize Flake8, but you could use PyLint and Flake8 at the same time if you wanted to. There would be some additional configuration for that because you might have some conflicts between the two applications. This is really just to introduce you to the idea of linting, and we will obviously utilize this throughout this course. So let's go ahead and install Flake8 and configure it within our Visual Studio Code settings. So back in our code base, first thing that we're going to need to do is actually install it. So we're going to pip install PyLint. Oh, no, we're not. We're going to pip install Flake8, sorry. I confused myself then. So Flake8, here it is on PyPy, if you wanted to take a look and access the documentations. We're told here, in actual fact, that Flake8 is a wrapper around three tools. And these are the three tools here. And in some respect, there's a lot of overlap here to some of the tools that we installed when we installed the Microsoft extension in Visual Studio Code. But this will provide some additional tools, which will essentially look for and scan our code base, analyze our code base, and look for errors. And it's just going to be really helpful and help us identify potential errors in our code to improve the code quality. Right, so go ahead and in the terminal, pip install Flake8. I've already installed mine. So get it installed, and now we're ready to configure the Visual Studio Code settings. I have made this script available in the course resources, so you can just go ahead and download it if you prefer, but we'll take you through this step by step. So let's just zoom in a little bit. Right, so now we need to implement PyLint. I keep calling it PyLint, a Flake8. it's like my brain is trying to tell me something here. Right, so let's go ahead and write this out. So python.linting. So now we want to set some of the linting options. So PyTest linting enabled. So I'm still laughing at, I keep mentioning PyLint. Okay, so true. And then python.linting.lintOnSave. So we want to lint on save. So we can set that to true. There we go. Then let's go ahead and enable Flake8. So python.linting.flake8 enabled. Okay. So we set that to true. And what's something wrong here? Is there something wrong here? python.linting.lintOnSave. Unknown configuration. So I've made a mistake here. python.linting. Lint, oh, I put line on save. That's why lint on save. Okay, so Flake8 enabled true. And then finally, we can go ahead and set some different options. Now, we have set the line length here to 88. So we are going to need to do with the same with Flake8. Now, if we didn't do that, for example, what would happen is that Flake8 is expecting a certain line length, and Black is then going to provide us another. So what's going to happen is that when we press save, Black is going to format our code to a line length of 88 and lint, and Flake8 is then going to tell us that there's a problem. So Black is going to format it for us on save, and then lint is Flake8. Oh, I keep doing it. Flake8 is going to then tell us that there's a problem because the line length is incorrect. So we just need to make sure that everything is matched up nicely. And so I'm just going to paste that in because it's fairly similar. So Python linting, oh, it's not really, it's not the same, is it? Linting flake8. It's been a long day. So flake8 args. Yeah, so the arguments that, so we're going to have max line length this time. So max line length. Yep. Okay. And then we can just set that to 88. There we go. Right, so hopefully that then will enable everything nicely. So we might want to actually close down Visual Studio Code and open up at this point just to kind of get everything refreshed. So let's go ahead and do that. So I'm just going to close Visual Studio Code. If you have closed Visual Studio Code and you only have one window open at that time, if you didn't have another Visual Studio Code window open, then when you open up Visual Studio Code again, it's going to open up where you left off when you close Visual Studio Code. So you should be back into your project. You notice that I'm not in my project, but it does give me some recent links here so I can get straight back into the project. So we're in GitHub here, so I can just click on that and that would take me then back to my project. So it's quite handy that when you do open up Visual Studio Code, it takes you back to the project, but I just need to activate the virtual environment again. And I need to then just CD into my DRF eCommerce. Right, so we should now have Flake8 installed and it should now be configured. So let's go ahead and take a look to see if we can kind of simulate a problem. Now, already we have an issue here. Right, so just ignore the issue for now, but you can see here in the actual content, at the bottom it says Flake8 F405. So in actual fact, Flake8 is analyzing our code here and it's potentially found a problem. So that's essentially what Flake8 is going to provide us. It's going to scan our code, analyze our code, and then give us some code errors, some code numbers here, F405 in this case, and then it's going to identify any potential issues. Now, what we can do here with these numbers, F405, for example, there are some times where, in this instance, for example, where you'll be told there's an error, but it's not necessarily an error. And you can configure Flake8 to kind of disable certain types of errors. So you can do a lot of filtering. There's lots of different options here. Now, we're just going to use it as is through the first section of this course. But I wanted to introduce that to you because it is very useful and it is going to help us identify any issues or problems in our code base. So just as another kind of light example here. Now, notice that there should be a new line at the end of the code. And if I hover over this squiggly line here at the end of this bracket here, you can see here that Flake8 has identified that no new line at the end of the file. So Flake8 W292. So if I press save, what's going to happen, of course, is black's going to take over. It's going to format this code. And then we should kind of remove that problem. So I press save. You can see black has taken over, formatted our code. And now you can see it's added a new line at the bottom here and our code error has now been removed. So although that again was a very simple example, hopefully throughout this project, we will make mistakes. There will be errors and we can utilize these tools to help diagnose the problem. Hopefully you did manage to get to the end because there's just one more task that we need to complete. Well, probably two tasks that we need to complete. So we need to decide whether we want to actually store the VS Code settings in our source code. Now, typically, we probably wouldn't do that. So in actual fact, we would want to go to our gitignore here, and then we would want to update it. Now, notice it's gray here because Visual Studio Code is kind of utilizing this gitignore file to work out what is actually being saved in source control and what isn't. So it's given us a nice indication here in actual fact as well of what's being saved and what isn't. So all the grayed out folders and files, if you're wondering, that is grayed out because it's not being tracked. So we already created a list earlier. And I did this on purpose because I knew that maybe you wouldn't get to the end of this tutorial. Some wouldn't. But you may have included a VS Code folder. So that's already set up already. So what we can now do is go into GitHub here and just make a new commit. We're now ready to finish that up. So I'll just type in NC for new commit again. Let's commit that to main and save that. And then let's push that to the origin. Obviously, we're now going to save all that into our GitHub repository online.